Hey drone pilots, we all know how uncomfortable it is to change the frequency of our VTX when it has a button, and more so if some part of the drone has to be dismantled. Well, in the METARACER team we have designed a system to be able to change the frequency of our VTX with a channel from our RC transmitter by using a switch to do this. We need a cable and a few betaflight commands. Attention to the video manual. We all have a drone with a transmitter that has a push button. A lot of times, that button is not easily accessible. This makes it very uncomfortable when it comes to racing friends. The first thing we have to do is use the multimeter with the VTX to locate the push button pin that is not negative. To do this, we measure between the negative of VTX, and we see that one side of the switch is negative and the other side is not. The side that is not negative is where we have to solder the cable that will connect to the controller. To do this, we connect a cable from the negative, minus, buzzer of our controller to the side of the VTX button that is not negative. Once the cable is welded, with everything mounted, we connect to betaflight and go to command mode. Here, we are going to type resource list, which is a list of all the resources. We can use this to allow us to locate the buzzer. Now, we can erase the function of the buzzer by writing resource beeper none. And then save it by typing save. Now, we go back into command mode to check it has been deleted by typing resource list. We can see that the C15 buzzer no longer appears. Now we can assign a user pin to this resource by typing resource pin 01C15 and typing save. Now we re-enter CLI, command mode, and type resource list. We can see that we have assigned pin 01 to resource C15. Now we can assign that pin to a user mode. We type get pin 01. And set config equals 1111. Then we type set pin YOL box equals 40,255,255,255 and save. Now we have to enter flight modes. We can see that a new command appears called USER1. We will assign this to one of the channels on our RC transmitter. In this case, I'm going to assign it to the non-blocking switch so I can change channels very quickly. Now I will put the margin exactly where the switch is activated. This is very important because we do not want the channel to change automatically when restarting the controller. Another very important thing is to failsafe our receiver so that it does not reach this margin. We also need to create a mix in the RC transmitter to prevent it from activating when the drone is armed. By doing this, we are activating the USER1 mode and giving signal to the VTX button. Once the cable is welded and everything is mounted to the switch of the transmitter, we will see how the channel changes. If we keep it pressed, we will see how the band changes. It's like having the push button directly on our RC transmitter. If we do not know which channel or band that we are on, we can use the scanner in our FPV glasses. We hope you find our video manual useful. Subscribe and like to be updated on our future videos. No.